वेलकम टू डेली करेंसी अपडेट फ्रॉम द करेंसी डेस्क। येस्टरडे वी विटनेस्ड अ मेजर डेप्रिसिएशन इन द इंडियन रुपी, मेनली एट्रिब्यूटेड टू द वीक यूरोपियन सेंटिमेंट्स। अगेन टुडे वी आर विटनेसिंग सम डेप्रिसिएशन इन द इंडियन रुपी, बट देन इट हैज स्टेबलाइज्ड अराउंड अ पर्टिकुलर रेंज। द करंट स्पॉट लेवल इज अराउंड 5580 एंड वी आर सीइंग सम रेंज बाउंड मूवमेंट अराउंड दिस लेवल। द मेन रीजन फॉर द वीकनेस इन द इंडियन रुपी इज द ग्लोबल ग्रोथ कंसर्न्स। नाउ दीज ग्लोबल ग्रोथ कंसर्न्स आर एट्रिब्यूटेड टू मेजर टू रीजन्स और रादर थ्री रीजन्स। फर्स्टली द चाइना, दैट इज द सेकेंड लार्जेस्ट इकनॉमी, द US इकनॉमी एंड द यूरोपियन यूनियन एज अ होल। कमिंग टू द चाइना फ्रंट, we had negative opening for the Asian markets in the morning session. This was attributed to some weak import data from China. Despite China registering an current account surplus, but its imports reduced. Market experts are attributing this reduction in imports to a weak domestic demand and relatively a slowdown in the Chinese economy. Also, market experts say that the demand for Chinese goods, which are majorly from the US economy, are also slowing down. So in the future, we could expect much more negative data from China, and a slowdown is clearly feared. Coming to the Japanese front, we had the current account surplus, which reduced for the Japan. At the same time, we had the machinery orders data, which were also much below expectations. These two negative data have boosted some risk averse demand in the Japanese yen, and due to this risk averse demand, we are witnessing some rally in the Japanese yen against the dollar as well as against the Indian rupee. Now coming to the European front, we have the European finance ministers meeting, which was a very lengthy one, and the outcome of the meeting yesterday was that the EU minister stated that the bailout package would be around 100 billion euros for the Spanish economy, and it would be given to the Spanish banks directly as promised earlier. But another positive was that in the month of July, they would disburse around 30 billion euros for the Spanish banks. So this again gave in a bit of stability for the euro and the pound on the downside. We had some mixed data on the European front. Firstly, we had the German trade balance data, which was very good and one of the best data in the past few months for the German economy. At the same time, we had the EU Centix investor confidence data, which was not as per expectations, again indicative of some negative and positive sentiments mixed. Also, the Spanish bond yields increased and the Italian bond yields sustained above 7%. 7% bond yields are generally considered as a tipping off point for economic default. So if the borrowing cost of any economy increases above 7%, we could well witness a default chance increase in that economy. So that is why the 7% level is crucial, and currently Italy and Spain bonds are clearly trading above that. Also, in terms of the European finance ministers meet, we did not have any cues regarding issue of any joint debt or intervention in the bond markets or a creating of any sort of funds for intervention in the bond markets so that the Spanish and the Italian yields can be controlled via market operations. So all in all, the sentiment still remains slightly bearish until unless there is any major change or maybe any major monetary stimulus being announced by the central governments around the world. Also, the USD index has stabilized around 83.40 levels. We have not seen any movement in the USD index. So at the same time, we can easily gauge that market is looking for some news or some direction, and market has not read much into the EU finance minister's meeting outcome. Also, the stabilizing of USD index indicates that there is some relative strength for the USD. So, in terms of the rupee against the dollar, euro, pound and yen, we recommend a buy based on the technical levels. The target for dollar can be kept at 56.50 and a buy position can be initiated at current levels. In terms of euro, we recommend a hold long with a target of 69.30 and a stop loss of 67.89. In terms of pound, we can keep a target above 87 levels in the spot. Also, in terms of yen, all long positions need to maintain a strict stop loss of 69.45. Thank you.